Afternoon has broken like the first morning. We are making tight. Can I talk about interrupting my flow?
No, because people might know he's a madman and I've come for a recipe.
This is, well, you'll have seen from the title, hopefully. You'll have seen the headline. It's a Thai green curry. Easy Thai green curry. Give it 2 minutes and we should be there. At the moment, Nadia Sawala, who is a celebrity master chef and presenter of Loose Women, in case you don't know who that is, coming in now. She's going to cook said dish. I'm a erstwhile husband who just dicks about a lot. And this is a fly swap.
Oh my God.
Okay.
I can't believe I forgot that I couldn't find the bloody can opener last time.
So we have a can opener crisis. Hello, Hilary Cannon, Francois Camanzulli, Gabrielle, Elizabeth Gordon, Tina Davis. Let me just introduce you to something that you probably didn't even know was here. Toffs, and you. Excuse me, you, come here. Subs, come here. I'm gonna be really kind to this little lady.
You've gotta stop doing this, Mark. It's getting...
Yeah. I've only done it once. Come out of the sun, Mark. Here's my little garden gnome.
Yes.
Have you seen the can opener?
No, I haven't had the can opener. Oh. If it was scissors, I might.
Everyone's saying hi, Nanny Di. Look.
Hello.
Say hello.
Hello, I'm doing tomorrow.
Do you think if I held you like a can opener, you could use your teeth to go like that?
Not my teeth, no.
No, hello, that's true. Hello. Wouldn't last long, would we? God. How are you doing?
I'm good.
Very stripy, very French. You feeling au français?
No.
Oh. Mum. We bought you a boogie board.
Oh, yeah.
But you can go boogie boarding. Surfing USA. So one thing we do know about my so-called father is that he liked the Beach Boys, isn't that right?
He did.
Yeah.
And he could surf.
And he could surf. Anyway, back over here. So just to remind you, we're making a Thai green curry. I'm going to test you in a minute. What are we making?
A Thai green curry, but we can't because we've got no effing can opener.
Mum, it's your fault.
I didn't notice. I borrow scissors, but I've never borrowed.
We watched The Disaster Artist whilst we were in... Oh, we're doing that again, are we? That's what we did last time. Oh, careful, Nads. Shrapnel.
I suppose that's all you can do, isn't it?
Hang on 1 minute. Let me find a screwdriver. That's what I did last time. God. You'll have to take that and talk to people.
Hi, everybody. How you doing?
Sorry, guys.
Can't believe this has happened again.
Okay.
We had a disaster the last time we did a cooking live because we didn't have a can opener. Who comes and steals a person's can opener? Who does that?
You got a hammer?
Anyway, once we start, it really will be incredible. So, lots of stuff at the moment about people needing to lose weight due to COVID. But I think there's a lot of that without a lot of help. And I think the thing is, people still aren't really clear on or believe that you can just make a really delicious, healthy dinner at home. Most days I'm going to post something on my Instagram for lunch that you can do that's really easy. No calorie counting, no cutting out carbs, no cutting out fat, no cutting out this, cutting out that. Just simple, easy to make. Healthy, delicious meals. Oh my God!
Do not ask any questions.
He's got the big hammer out. So on these cooking lives, Mondays and Wednesdays, I just have a look at what I've got in the cupboard, and then I cook something. So that's how we've come to Thai chicken curry. Also, Nanny Di is here, and she likes chicken curry, and she's very difficult to feed because she's very, very fussy. So it's something she'll eat. Now, as always, when I cook, I'll give you different options. I'm going to give you the simplest. He's got the pliers out now. Okay, that'll do, babe. That'll do. We're in. We're in. Here you go.
Ridiculous.
If I had a hammer, I'd hammer in the morning. I'd hammer in the evening. All over this land. Anyway, turning around.
And the other thing that I will do is give you the options always of how you can adapt the dish to veganism, vegetarianism, etc. Right, so first of all, I've got in here 2 large chicken breasts cut very small. This is a real key to cooking this dish really easily, really quickly without any worry of over dry chicken or anything else. So what I usually do is put a spoonful. Now, I'm not a massive believer in sauces, like processed sauces, because I've always got a lot of salt and sugar. But these green paste curries are a must. And there's, I don't think there's any sugar in them. They really are. They're just a paste of things like lemongrass and all the lovely herbs and spices that you need for a good paste. That takes ages to make because you have to buy all the different ingredients. So it's a really good store cupboard ingredient. And you see the way I'm just mixing that in, even before we start, into the chicken. Now you could do this the night before or in the morning or whatever, so that those, so the flavors really permeate the chicken, because we're not gonna cook the chicken for too long, because it's chicken is breast. We're not gonna cook it for too long. It's literally gonna just poach. So if it doesn't have enough time in the sauce, it won't get the flavor, yeah.
Guys, can you tell me what the sound's like? Because we've had a chat with YouTube and they can't help us very much, unfortunately.
At all.
Well, no, at all. Oh, it's good. Can you hear Nadia all right?
That's good.
Oh, it's very good. It's fine. Oh, good.
Woohoo!
Hey.
Okay, so I'm just going to put that chicken in.
That's fantastic.
It's just fantastic. Right.
So we have some lemongrass here from the garden.
As I said, all the way through, I will give you options. I'm cutting up some spring onions. You don't have to put spring onions in. You could just put any onions that you have. It's nice spring onions. Oh, just to say, this is not a traditional Thai green curry. This is not how they would do it in Thailand. This is a bastardized version that's just easy for us.
Lots of people asking about your rash. Faith Goodman.
It's still there. But the COVID nurse said she doesn't think it's COVID.
Yeah.
So that's good.
I'm going to buy you a tin opener, Nad.
Yeah?
Yeah, really nice one.
Wow, excited.
Yeah, and I'm going to wrap it up. I'm going to hide it in your bed.
So everything that I'm doing with the sauce here, you can do for a vegan or a vegetarian. You just don't put the chicken in at the end, simple. Mm. So first things first is, now I always used to use coconut oil when I was making Thai curry, but actually, I mean, there's those that believe in coconut oil and those that don't, but I was talking to a nutritionist the other day and she really does believe it's not good for cholesterol. So I'm just going to use a plain sunflower oil. Now, try not to use too much, but I do not believe in no fat. I just don't believe in it. I think it makes us depressed. And I think if you're trying to lose weight, reduce your fat, but I would say don't go to no fat. I mean, that's probably too much, actually. That's actually too much.
There's just a big hole in it for someone who's worried if there are two holes in it.
First thing I'm going to do is just soften off my spring onions. As I say, you don't have to use spring onions. You could use some normal onions. You could use some chives. You don't have to use any onion. It will still be... I'm going to, as we get there, I'll show you how you can do it easy. The very, very basis of this that would still make a gorgeous Thai green curry is to do what I did there. Put the paste, put the coconut cream, bung it back in, it will still be delicious. You can get it on the table in 5-6 minutes. I've steamed some brown rice.
Is it dangerous?
What?
The rice.
No, you could.
You've made me scared of rice.
It's bad, rice is bad when you leave it out and don't heat it up properly, it's bad for you.
Do you get that, guys? Don't eat rice when it's cold, is that right? Well, how do you have sushi?
No. Be careful with this.
Oh, yeah.
It's not you can't eat rice when it's cold. You can't leave rice out of the fridge. And if you're heating up rice, every single grain must be piping hot because you can get food poisoning from it.
So you're talking about if you reheat it?
Reheat it.
Is that clear?
But also, if rice has been left out of the fridge a long time, like if you're making a rice salad in the morning to take to work and you're not going to eat it to 2 o'clock and it's a hot day, you could get very ill.
So just remember, guys, remember, kids, rice kills if not treated with respect.
It can, like no joke. Okay, so we just soften those down. I would actually, if I was just eating this, I would have those a bit crisper, but Mark would like crunchy onion. So just put that out. Okay.
That was exciting.
Now, if you are vegan or vegetarian, you could do that. You could add all sorts of things to that. Whatever vegetables you like, you would let those spring onions soften a bit and then chuck in your vegetables.
Not a lot of stuff to sort of go off to here, is there? There's like a tin and there's a...
It's not. So now I'm going to use this curry paste. Ooh. And I really like this make. I think it's really good. And lots of people don't do this stage, which is to fry the curry paste first. You just dry fry it. Unless you do, how are you going to get those flavours to come out?
Oh. I don't know. How are you?
It's smelling so nice now.
I'm going to do it quick. Hey guys, if you're liking what you're smelling and you're liking what you're seeing, and I am because she's lovely and it looks tasty, hit the thumbs up button and say thank you, like you, love you very much.
Thank you, like you, love you. Okay, now absolutely you don't have to do this bit, and in fact I don't think they do add ginger, if I'm right.
I love a bit of ginger
into
and everything.
Thai curry. But we're all trying to be really healthy at the moment. Ginger, fresh ginger is really good for you.
Yeah.
Reduces inflammation in the body. All inflammation. Inflammation is what causes dis-ease.
We like you too, Trace J.
Okay. You don't need to add that.
I've never been to Thailand. Have you?
No.
No. I think I'd like to go.
I think I'd like to go.
Some of the beaches. Have you seen the film The Beach with Leonardo DiCaprio?
Right, so that is cooking now. Yep. So now I'm just
going to
add.
Oh, look at this.
A little of the coconut milk. Just a word on the coconut milk.
Yeah.
If you like a super creamy Thai green curry,
yes,
you would need to use the full fat curry.
Right.
Coconut milk. But we're not. We're using the light one. Better for you.
Mum, do you like Thai green curry? You can't slope through like that, Mum.
No, I'm not sloping.
You're trying to. Oh. Hey up, she's going over. She's over!
Oh,
what's happening? That was very sudden.
I had to bend my back.
You're right. Oh, Mum. People are going to say I've been mean to you even though I haven't done anything.
No, you haven't been mean to me.
No.
I think I might have had enough though.
Yeah, just relax.
All right.
Yeah.
Like this.
Sing a song.
Wish I could fly. Shut right up to the sky, but I can't.
I can't.
You can't!
Right. Then I add just the teeniest splash of nam pla, which is fish sauce.
Ooh.
Always goes in. Don't worry if you haven't got it, doesn't matter, you don't have to add it.
Always goes a long way. I once remember some of this spilling in a cupboard and it stank for years.
But it doesn't stink or taste, you would not know there's that's in there.
Yeah, it's amazing, isn't it?
So we're letting that bubble away. So again, if you were vegan or vegetarian, at this point you could just put your veggies in.
Oh, look at this.
One word though, if you are going to put in aubergines,
yeah,
because traditional Thai green curry has those little baby aubergines, don't just put them in, you have to fry them first. But if you're really watching your health, spray them in oil or just brush them in oil, put them in a hot oven for 20 minutes. Because if you just put them in, oh, it will be so disgusting.
Check out my lemongrass pot, guys.
So I'm going to put a lemongrass stick in. You don't need to. It is extra. This is extra. You know, it's just dried. You can keep them in it. I'm using everything from the stalk cupboard.
Well, that's kind of answered my question then. That's answered my question. They need to be thicker, the stalks in mine, before you can cut them.
I've never used fresh.
Yeah. What you do is they grow thick enough. I've grown them before, and once they're thick, but they're really fresh and vibrant.
Oh, my God, I'm so excited.
Yeah, so am I.
Right. So that's bubbling away. Don't forget, if anyone is Thai, this is a bastardised Thai curry.
Don't say that word.
It is not a genuine article, but it is delicious.
She said bastard. Did you hear that?
So the next thing I do is I always add a pinch of sugar. I think in Thai, with a proper Thai curry, they use palm sugar, but we haven't got any of that. I'm just going to put a pinch of brown sugar, not too much. You don't have to add it if you want a no sugar, 5. I just put a teeny bit.
So lemongrass is a bit like bay leaves. You put it in but take it out at the end.
Yeah. Okay, spring onions.
Sue Cope just blew me a kiss. Don't worry, Mum, I'm not leaving Nad. Don't worry.
And a teeny pinch of salt. You don't have to add the salt if you don't want to. And look at that. You won't believe it, but we have our Thai green curry.
I have to say, I'm going to say this loud, and I'm going to say it proud. It smells divine, Nanny Dai.
It does smell divine.
It does smell really good.
Just going to lie down upstairs. upstairs.
Yeah, Mum, are you all right? You're not going to...
I'm fine.
Yeah? You're sure you're not ill?
Fine. No,
yeah?
I'm good.
I mean, if you are on the cusp, give us a shout and we'll film it, yeah?
I'm not off yet. Okay. Definitely.
You sure you're all right, Mum? I'll bring you up a drink and a cup of tea in a minute.
No, don't.
Oh, bless her. She cuts a poor little figure. Mum, you're like Paddington Bear.
No. Am I?
Oh, Bear of Little... Oh, no, that's not Paddington. That's Winnie the Pooh.
Winnie the Pooh.
Oh, Mum.
Oh.
Oh, Mum. Bouncy, flouncy,
right,
fun, fun, fun.
Very odd. Thai basil is so gorgeous.
Tell me about it. I grew it 2 years ago.
Yeah, we don't have any, so I'm just going to put a little bit of cheese-free pesto.
Can I just ask quickly, is it your...
No, hang on, let me just finish what? Cheese-free pesto. So don't worry. You absolutely don't need to put that in. Oh, I wanted to make this, I haven't got any pesto. I'm just doing that because I like that basil-y flavour in it. Sorry,
but
what did you
want to
say?
You've never overtly said what your most favourite basil is, and I'm always getting different types. But is Thai basil your favourite?
No, no, Thai basil is my favourite for Thai food, but it's
oh.
Especially Italian.
Oh, Christ. Okay.
So now I'm going to pop that chicken in.
There's another bit in the bowl.
Oh.
Yeah, it's feeling really left out that bit.
So what I'm going to do is just bring this up to the bubble.
Yeah.
Up to the boil.
Marvel DC Supergirl 1919, Mark, we need a giggle.
Doesn't that look...
It looks delicious.
Okay, you can chat to them now.
No, it's delicious.
What I was going to say next is, so now, brought that up to the bubble.
Yeah.
And when... it's bubbling, then I turn it off. Because I've cut the chicken really, really small, and the chicken is at room temperature, don't bring it straight out of the fridge because it'll be tough.
Faith Goodman asking, what is the name of that fish sauce again? Is that it?
Napalm.
Napalm? Can you hold it up?
Nampla. But you can just, it will always say fish sauce underneath it.
There you go.
So what I'm going to do now is turn that off.
Right.
And that's all the cooking that chicken needs.
So it's just going to stew?
But it's really important. No, it's going to poach, not stew.
Okay.
It's really important that you just cut one open to check it's cooked through. Okay. Just while I...
Tidy up.
Everything, you can have a chat now.
I wish I could fly right up to the sky, but I can't.
I can't!
I wish I could fly right up to the sky, but I can't. I can't!
That was Orville. How did Nadia learn how to cook so well? Deborah Holdsworth. Nadia learned to cook so well.
Because I come from a family of cooks, so I just learned by being around cooks. But then I read quite a lot about cooking.
They are a family. I mean, you know, like many families have different passions, and obviously, you know, their passion is absolutely food. And they're all fabulous cooks, and they live it, they breathe it. They can have great long conversations about just a garlic. I don't know how, but they can. And yeah, it's very rich and it's very, very, very lovely. I'm not at all. I'm saying it's a fact. I could not talk about ingredients for as long as you do, but you bring them to life. And if you didn't know them as well as you did, you wouldn't be able to make nice food. So there you go. So, you know, when you're surrounded by it, I mean, my family never talked about food, which is why none of us can cook for toffee. Is the rash an extension of what is happening on your hands? Asks Audrey Sargent.
Maybe.
Yeah, I thought that.
It jolly well could be, but we're going to find out. Because my COVID test will be back soon.
At the start of lockdown, Jodie, I started my own herb garden. I've got mint, oregano, basil and thyme. Need dishes to use them on now. Oh, I know, I've just grown some English thyme and some Zeta Zata. And it smells so lovely. A sort of oregano, Middle Eastern oregano.
Is anyone going to have a go at making this?
I'm going to turn around. Are you going to have a little look? Can we have a look?
Oh. Is anyone going to have a go at making it?
I think everyone's going to have a go at making it, yeah.
Oh, look at that.
Chi-Chi is back very
so
soon.
So whatever vegetables you want. So you see how I'm just cutting it
yes.
open
yes.
to have a look?
Absolutely.
Just have a few minutes.
That, can I say, that looks so much more inviting than you ever get from most takeaways. My... Oh, Christ.
Bum, hole.
What was that?
Oh, pesto all over the sodding floor. Oh, that will properly stain on the wood. Go away. Go away.
Domestic goddess.
Domestic
goddess. the ones that I get, does anyone else find this? When I get a Thai green curry, I get really annoyed because I feel like they really sort of pad it out with bamboo shoots. There's too much bamboo shoots in there. Is anyone else?
Because they're throwing the chicken in, they cut it really, really thin.
Yeah.
Because what they've got is a big vat of sauce, and then they'll put it in the thing and they'll chuck the sauce on top, and the chicken never tastes of the curry, does it?
No.
Because they haven't...
I find it very hard these days. People are asking, why does Nadia not say Mark anymore? She actively refuses to, because she doesn't want to give me the satisfaction. So I might have to find a slapping instrument. And chase her.
Oh my God, so fragrant.
Shout out to Katie Johnston.
Hi, Katie Johnston.
My dad, a cook. My granddad, a cook. Granny Baker, I'm cook. Love it. Raspberry Mojito Girl, December 1982. It's ready? Spinning round like a clown on acid. There we go.
Right, so I just brought it up to the bubble a bit more. So it just poached into... Be warned though, you have to cut the chicken small. It has to be room temperature. Otherwise, you can't turn the gas off. You would have to keep bubbling it.
Right. So dangerous rice.
So just a little word about, because if we're thinking about, a lot of people are wanting to get healthier, COVID healthy.
Yeah, I'm quite relieved you're not doing a fake away this week, to be honest, because we all need to lose a bit of weight.
Yeah. So, what's this?
Rice.
Lovely, gorgeous, fabulous brown rice.
Now, you always make me get brown rice options whenever I'm out, don't you?
That's about how much rice one should have.
Is it really?
Yeah.
Wow.
So we usually, don't we, as people, we pile our rice and we put our... That's about what you're looking at. That's a healthy amount of rice. And if I cannot stress to you enough how brown rice... is so much better for you.
Yeah.
And the thing is about it is, it fills you up. When you have white rice, white rice...
Shoots your energy up and then you crash.
Shoots your energy up and then you crash and then you're hungry again. That's why, you know why often after Chinese everybody's starving?
No, no.
It's because there's so much sugar in the food and there's white rice, so your insulin spikes up really bad.
That's why I'm hyperactive when I'm in a sushi bar, and then when I come out, I'm devastated.
Yeah. But what I would say is white rice is really nice sometimes. So sometimes have it, but just more often have brown rice.
Are you pleased I salvaged your spoon from the garden?
What spoon?
The one that you're using.
Why did you have to say
No, that? It's been cleaned. We've bleached it, but I'm just saying I found it. It's a very good one.
Lots of nice veg. Oh, it's so fragrant with the lemongrass.
Could you do this with prawns?
Yep, absolutely anything. Prawns are the same.
Vegan option?
The vegan is just don't put the chicken in, just put lots of veg.
Okay.
Because it is totally vegan otherwise. Unless coconut milk isn't vegan. No, it is, it's only a coconut.
What are you doing? Putting some nuts in,
I'm
what's
just
going on?
A little peanuts.
That's a bit fancy, a garnish of peanuts.
A bit fancy, but again, not traditional.
All right.
If I had some coriander now, I would put coriander on it, but Mark doesn't like coriander. If I had some basil leaves. So you can go absolutely basic where you just fry the paste and then you add the coconut, you stir it in, you drop the chicken in. It would still be nice. Those little extras I just got to you.
Hit the thumbs up if you want one of us to taste it.
Yeah.
And if you get us over, I don't know, 250 thumbs up, I'll eat it. Go on, hit the thumbs up. Come on, guys, you know you want to. I've got a rice. Yeah, and anyway, brown rice really makes the world a difference. I wish you could get sushi with brown rice. You can in America.
You can more these days.
You can in the States.
Actually, sushi isn't nearly as healthy as people think because it's white rice
and then it's sugar
in the white rice. And then quite often the ones we like the most have the mayo in.
Hit the thumbs up and I'll taste it.
So... Yeah, you just try it. If you've never tried brown rice before, just try it. You'll be amazed. What I would say is put some salt in the water. It makes it a bit tastier. We all love brown rice now. None of them wanted brown rice, but they all love it.
Why do people have a problem with brown rice?
Because...
It tastes a bit more split, doesn't it? It's more nutty, organic.
But when you get used to it, you will be fuller for longer. It's better for your bowels. It's better for everything.
I look a bit smug when I... When I go to Wagamama's, I get a chicken katsu. And I get brown rice.
I know, every time he orders brown rice now, it goes to me.
Yeah, I do.
It's taken me years. But you like it now.
I do like it. I prefer
it. You actually say, oh, no. Cause
it's
what
more substantive. Come on, hit the thumbs up, guys.
Another tip, guys. Another tip. See how much rice I've made?
Yeah.
So I'm going to put this in little bags. I've told this to people before. And then I'm going to put it in the freezer. Because when you freeze your rice and then you defrost it, heat it up, it reduces the carb in it massively. I think by 30%, 40%.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay, we're there. Let's do it. Who's tasting it?
You, it's your dinner.
Oh, right, fantastic. Spun round. Spun round.
Ooh, ah.
I lost my
Mr. Ma.
I don't know where my knickers are.
Well, let's have a
look
into the
plate. I think I left them in my car.
Oh.
See, yeah, I do like the goopiness of brown rice. Going in. Not going in.
The other thing, guys, if you don't like rice at all, or if you don't want any carbs, do some cauliflower rice or courgettes, or do it on a big bed of spinach. It'd be delicious.
Very succulent chicken.
Yeah,
lovely.
It's not overcooked. It's lovely.
Tasty.
Nice?
Yeah.
Mm. Turn around. So there you go, guys. Remember, you could have that with brown rice noodles. You could have it with cauliflower rice. You could have it with courgette, spiralized courgette. What I would say is don't cook the spiralized courgette. Put the hot sauce on and let it just wilt a bit. And he's off.
If I had a hammer.
A hammer
in
the
morning.
Anyway, I've got to go now because I've got to go. Look what I made my dad. And it's in one of the vlogs. I've made him a gorgeous chicken stew. I've been cooking for hours. I've made him a chicken stew, so I need to take that over for him because he's not very well.
Very finely at the end of it.
Please, guys, hit the like button and hit the subscribe and the notification bell.
And for those of you who want a cheap thrill, put your eyes really close up to the screen now. Like, really close up. Go on, put your eyes up against the screen.